Your life, whether you like it or not, is already being directly influenced by AI. You've discovered this video in particular out of billions because the neural network behind YouTube's recommendation system has specifically chosen you to see this video's thumbnail. These algorithms are the backbone of various social media platforms. They control what you see and what content surfaces to different audiences. For the most part, they work pretty well. However, they also provide a breeding ground for something darker. Another, more sinister way AI can affect you online. A way that plants a seed in your mind that you might never realize. In 2019, Elon Musk's research organization, OpenAI, unveiled details on its latest experiment. It's an AI called GPT-2, and it's a transformer-based language model, which basically means that it's an AI that specializes in writing text. Its goal was simple: predict the next word given all previous words within some text. Give it an input, and the AI would complete what you wrote. It was trained on text from 8 million web pages, which is about 40 gigabytes of data. Language models aren't exactly new, but this was at a scale that had never been done before. The AI learned how to write in English with unprecedented quality. What it wrote made sense and was eerily coherent. It also demonstrated abilities in question answering, reading comprehension, summarization, and translation. These tasks were never the main objective of the AI, indicating that it learned new, high-level concepts about language without any human directive. Tasked with writing an article about unicorns, the AI produced some consistent, intelligible text that you could undoubtedly pass off as written by humans. Honestly, it's pretty creepy. A robot doing all of your homework is the dream of pretty much any school student. The idea of having a personal essay-writing AI might be closer than you think. The website talktotransformer.com is based on the GPT-2 model mentioned earlier, and will be using it to demonstrate the technology. This AI, in specific cases, can form reasoning and provide evidence behind any belief, ideology, or concept. Based on a couple of keywords, this AI can generate logical essays and short responses that you could turn into your teacher. To demonstrate this, inputting the phrase "Australia is known for" returns a 112-word paragraph about the country's influence on self-driving cars, with even cited sources. These types of language-based AI could start interacting with your daily life pretty soon. Most phones have a virtual assistant, such as Siri or Google Assistant, and they could get a pretty big upgrade with new developments in chatbot technology. Google AI developed Mina, a chatbot that can flawlessly imitate natural human conversation. Traditional chatbots have very close-ended conversations. Mina, on the other hand, would ask about the user's day. She would help the user find things to do, such as recommending movies, and even offering her own insight. Mina was trained on 8 times more data than GPT-2, except all the data it's trained on was from real human conversations. Google has not yet released Mina to the public. But at the end of April 2020, Facebook had also developed their own chatbot as well, called Blender. They're claiming that Blender is even more human than Mina, having the ability to express knowledge, personality, and even empathy. Unlike Google, Facebook also open-sourced Blender. The future is looking pretty bright. Soon, these engaging conversations could be accessible straight from your phone, making us feel a little less lonely. These language-based AI systems are only going to keep improving from here on out. Despite that, there's a reason why OpenAI chose not to initially release the model and the code for GPT-2, and it stems from the deep fear that it would be used maliciously. How do you know what you see online is real? You click on an article and read it, it's coherent, and it sounds believable. You read a post on Facebook and you think the same. You see a tweet with a controversial opinion and it has tons of likes. Seems legit, right? Slowly but surely, that opinion that seemed pretty popular grows to become yours. Estimates place at least 40% of the internet traffic we have now originating from bots, not humans. There's already swarms of misleading content polluting the internet, but you've already heard of fake news, so what's the big deal? What happens when most of everything you see online is now generated by language-based AI? Using the concepts these AI systems have learned about language, they inevitably have the ability to generate text that is believable, but not 100% true. When formatting arguments, the AI is able to predict when quoted evidence is necessary. It uses made-up names and articles which advocate its opinions. These are only some examples of what can make these generated texts even more convincing. To show you an example of this in use, we made a pretty radical opinion and ran it through the GPT-2 model. We told the transformer, "Hitler was a good man because." The results speak for themselves. The AI came back with a wide variety of responses that all try to uphold the given statement. Now, imagine this, but with any opinion you want to enforce. Yet, what's scary about AI-generated fake news isn't necessarily the fake news itself. What's scary is how widespread misinformation can become. Currently, organizations have to use humans to write these articles and comments, but there can only be a limit to that. These new systems give any bad actor the ability to essentially manufacture opinions at scale. By controlling language and what people see online, you're able to skew people's opinions and perspectives to what you want them to be. Public opinion is more important than we can imagine. Public opinion embeds itself in law. It sparks revolution. Control public opinion, and on a grand enough scale, you can change laws, and you can suppress revolution. You can fundamentally control a population. This all sounds pretty 1984-ish. The fact that OpenAI initially didn't release their transformer network to the public didn't bode well with the machine learning community. There was fierce controversy with this decision. OpenAI wasn't so open after all. The only significant barrier to acquiring and fine-tuning an AI like this for your own purposes is computational power. It would cost around $40,000 in cloud computing resources to train a model at the scale of GPT-2. This is a lot for the average person, but sadly, in the eyes of a moderately interested organization, it isn't. It's only a matter of time before a vastly improved model could be commissioned for use privately by an unethical organization. Making the AI private while also extensively documenting how it worked only drove a bridge between the general public and the wealthy. The normal researcher wouldn't have the resources to replicate this AI system. Thus, regular people wouldn't be prepared to face this technology. However, 9 months later, OpenAI had actually released the full-size model to the public. Their statement indicated that they did this to help people better prepare for and detect synthetic text. OpenAI themselves stated that detection is challenging, and that it's within the realm of possibility that these types of AI can be fine-tuned to generate propaganda for a variety of purposes. We might never know if these technologies are being used right now, but we can be vigilant knowing that it's completely feasible that they are. You can easily protect yourself from misinformation by following a few simple measures. Measures including, but not limited to, fact-checking, cross-referencing, and using reputable sources. Sadly, the majority of people don't do this. But we can start now. Let us know your thoughts about this topic in the comments section below. If you found this video interesting, feel free to like the video and subscribe for more. We've recently launched our Patreon page, where you can receive some cool perks like early access to videos and behind-the-scenes access to our production process. We thank anyone that chooses to support us. It helps us continue to provide the best quality content we can.